I really wanted to give you the last word, and I just have to respond to the notion.
I could have said no, but I'm saying yes.
I appreciate that. I do, and you're the chair, and you get to determine the speaking order of these proceedings, but I just have to respond to two notions. Number one, the idea that I would say, first of all, of the Senate package that was intended to prevent gun violence, a bunch of members on our side of the aisle did vote for a bunch of those bills. I have to respond to the notion that the bill, there was one bill particularly for safety in New York, which is about having a police officer in every school. My father was a police officer for 33 years. We all deal with police officers, and we all have a sense of how police officers can keep our students safe, how they can keep our constituents safe in all kinds of contexts. The idea that we oppose those bills for anything other than the reason that we don't believe that there are effective ways to address the problem is concerning to me. If you don't believe this bill will be effective, I think you should vote against it. If you believe it's effective, then sure, my colleagues should vote for it. But I really want to respond to the notion that this is somehow about keeping an issue alive. And I think you've said that publicly before this hearing, this meeting. But the politics of this, if I wanted an election issue, I would not be sitting here crying, and I would not have had individual conversations with a majority of the members of this House about this bill for the last several months. I would not have introduced the bill in 2014 when I was a majority member of the Senate, of the Assembly rather, and didn't have any particular sense of how the politics of 2018 would be working. This bill has been introduced for no other purpose than that it is highly likely that if we pass this bill, fewer New Yorkers will die of gun violence. And again, it is tailored in such a way that the Republican governor of the state of Florida signed a bill like this into law. Unfortunately, it took the Parkland tragedy for him to do that. But we have an opportunity in the state to get ahead of this problem. This bill, whatever you think of it, we'll have continuing debates about other bills. This bill is a bill that will reduce lives. It frankly will give Republicans who want to vote for it an answer to what are you willing to do about gun violence. And there's no partisan politics in my effort to get this done.